thank you everybody for coming in. It is my great pleasure to introduce this section of the unconference with Every Child Counts. So I'll hand over to our presenter.
Thank you, Sassy. So good morning, everyone. Namaste from India. So let's begin. So first of all, I would like to thank you, ABCD Conference, for giving this opportunity. So our topic, we are going to talk about it, Every Child Count, experimental narrative of growing up with the dignity of the children in crisis from the Vanava and Maharashtra Community of India. So I'll run the slide. We'll have, so every training and session, we should have some ground rules. Let's run through the ground rules. So my slide is visible. Please, can anybody can show the thumb up? So I understand my slide is visible. Runjun, it's visible. Yeah, thank you so much, Judy. Yeah. So first of all, thank you all the supporter, all the institute organization from the global who are supporting this great initiative and giving the platform to everyone to showcase their talent. So once again, thank you ABCD Conference and all the supporter and sponsor. I would like to acknowledge the team of ABCD Conference for giving this wonderful platform to share our story, alumni children for sharing that experience with us, and committed community developments for giving me this opportunity to represent them today. As we are aware, any conference and training, we have certain rules. So let's make this process a smooth and are helpful to each other to understand better. So I would request everyone to keep, please remain muted their audio unless to reduce speaking or to avoid background noise. I would like to also request, please limit it turning your camera off on as of much as possible when it's required. Technical support team, there is a designated tech support person on the hosting team. If she's the stay, thank you, stay. And she's a very supportive person. Thank you. So if you need any assistance, you can message in chat box. Okay. And yes, we also have a recording to document this program. So this session will be recorded. If you would prefer not to be captured, keep your video off. It is up to, it is open for you all. Let's start. I would like to request everyone, those who are present and attending the session, please introduce yourself in chat box, share your first name, pronouns, location, if applicable, and the acknowledgement of your country land from which you are belonging currently. So I request everyone to just share a basic detail which help us to acknowledge, and we'll get to know more about how share our experience. So this is something very big. Is coming ABCD on conference. I think we will have access once the conference ends. Yes, until we start, your microphone speaker waiting to be going on that. So take care. So I think let's start. If anybody has any question or anybody want to, or we will wait for 5 minutes more. Let's people join. And then we can start. Stacy?
Yes.
So we will wait for 5 minutes more. Let's people join.
Yeah, people have been joining as you've been talking.
Okay. I can see like my chat box is bombarding. Yeah. Thank you, Ray from Sydney, Olivia from Australia, Angela from Australia, Ashok sir from India, Biji Gill from Sydney. Yeah. Good to see you all. And I'm excited to share our experience and in the pandemic and also the journey what CCDT committed community development is imparting in the community. Health, Yeah, thank you, Wilton, from South Australia. Runjun from Mumbai. Thank you, Runjun. Runjun is my co-host as well. So talking about CCDT, so let's keep, let the people join. Meanwhile, we can have a more discuss about what our organization do and what we are today. So community development trust, it's almost completed 3 decades. So we are 31 old organization based in Mumbai. And we work in the area of child development, child protection, development empowerment, as well as we also work in the area of mother and child maternal rights. So CCDT over the past three, we have a several program with the support of government funding, corporate, and also the NGOs. So we closely work with the important government stakeholder like Child Welfare Committee, Mumbai National AIDS Control Society, Leprosy Equal Society, and there are many more organizations who closely work with and supporting since a decade. So today we are going to talk about, as our theme is Every Child Count. So CCDT always focus that every child should count in spite of their background, gender, or the financial condition. But for us, every child count, the mental end and the development of the child is very important. Yes, and also, just a minute. Hello. Yes.
Apologies, I believe we're just having some technical difficulties. We're just trying to resolve that at the second.
Hello. Yeah, I think that's a network issue. Yeah. So in India, it's raining and it's a rainy season in India, and it's morning 9:30 a.m. So cold weather in India. So we'll have little bit fluctuation. So can I request everyone to share their timing? It will help me as like I will not boredom. So like in India, the timing is 9:30 a.m. morning. I would like people can share their timing of the country currently. So Judy, in Melbourne, what is the time? It is afternoon, morning?
2:10. 2:10.
2:10 in the afternoon. Anybody else would like to share? Sony, I think you are from India. So I think we have the same timing. It's 9:30 a.m. Yeah, Hello. So Sonia, you're based in India,
in Mumbai. In Pune.
Pune.
I'm in Pune. Oh,
very close past.
Yes.
Okay.
Thanks, Deepak.
So Yeah, welcome, Sonia. So I think let's begin with the presentation. Or, ठीक है. So I'll start my screen sharing. Is it visible?
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you. Let me do the full screen and then we'll start. So let's start. I think I'm not getting that option to full screen, but I think if it is visible, Stacey.
Yes, it is visible. And does it help if you go to slideshow up the top on the menu bar? It's 6 in.
Okay.
Along the top, so it has file, home, insert, design, transitions, animations, and then slideshow. If you can click on slideshow, or just above the top where it has the little save button, there's the backwards and then the there we go.
So once again, namaste, everyone. Good morning from India. Yes, thank you, Stacey. So a warm welcome. And thank you so much, the participants who are joining and listening our story and experience from India. And happy to share our story. So our topic is Every Child Counts, the experimental narrative of growing up with the dignity of the children in crisis for vulnerable and marginalized community. Myself, Deep Tripathi. And one of my colleague, Ms. Runjhun, a part of this initiative, and she's been supporting me as a co-host. So talking about CCDT, we CCDT Committee Trust, we are 30-year-old organization. We are based out of Mumbai, India. We have been working from last 31 years in the area of child protection and development, mother, child, and adolescent youth empowerment. But our core theme of our organization is child protection and to support their development till they reintegrate and restore to the society. I think there's a network glitches. Sorry. Here is a second slide. I think it takes time. So I'll introduce myself. And yes, you can see the picture Deepak? Of Ms. Runjhun. She's my colleague. Hello.
Deepak, do you want to turn off your video? Then maybe the bandwidth for audio will improve.
So because... it's big, stucking somewhere, and I think this network glitches is there because it's raining here.
आप वीडियो ऑफ करोगे ना तो बैंडविड्थ मिल जाएगा हमें,
मुझे लगता है वही दिक्कत है। या हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर।
जस्ट एनीवन से के यस, या थैंक यू सो मच। सो टॉकिंग अबाउट myself, so I have experience overall 15 years in the development and corporate. I am holding the degree of MBA and training in development from the National Institute of Business Study. I have been working in the area of HIV/AIDS, health, livelihood, education, gender equality, and WASH. Over the period of year, I have supported several training programs with the government and supported the Global Fund. You can see Runjun, one of my colleagues, she is with me. Runjun is in a media and communication professional with 4 years of working experience across the sector. She holds a postgraduate diploma in the communication for development from Xavier's Institute of Communication from Mumbai. She has also done her BA degree in English from the University of Delhi. So this is our small introduction. I'll go ahead with the next slide. I think this slideshow taking time, so I'll go in the normal slideshow. Yes. So yes, here we are. So committed community development trust. Yes. So committed community development was working in the mobile community across Maharashtra. We has gone to the last mile to reach out the children and family in the crisis. Over the last 3 decades, committed community development trust had impacted the life of more than 2 million individuals through its various program and intervention. Yes, but we always focus our core theme, child protection and the development. So committed community development trust working in the area of child protection and development for over the 31 years in the state of Maharashtra. Today, we would like to leverage this platform to introduce our program and successfully initiate. Let's talk about our values. So yes, our values is very significant towards the direct benefit of a community. Overall, our program are directed restoring the hopes for children, we believe, restoring hopes from better future of the child. Yes, the rights-based intervention, we totally agree in the rights-based intervention about the justice and equality of the child. We work towards the building the longer relationship for the long-term relationship to support mutual and the community feelings. So we make sure our children, our community have long relation and also to be in the part of society, for the society and by society. We work towards the race, the awareness, we create the leader for change and make the ambassador who are the new change maker in the society. So our program also tailor in that way where we can support a child who are the future, as we are aware that every child is a future of a society and country. So we do and we work in that area where the child is opportunity to explore and enhance their knowledge, and also the community who are parents and not getting the opportunity to explore. So we are here to provide the platform and the opportunity. When we talk about stepping back and only extension for the children and adolescents to realize their full potential, yes. So this is where we create the platform and the opportunity where the child get to know their potential, providing several capacity building, linking with them vocational trainings so that they realize their full potential and do for themselves. So in short, we are making a self-reliant adolescents and youth so they can take and lead the society. talking about community driven NGOs, yes, children being the center of our UNIS, yes, as our goal and theme of the organization, yes, we always design a program and support a program which has a child centric agenda. So that is one of our USP, we can say, where we focus what child's interest, and accordingly we support the child for their self-development. And in that area, we try to motivate and driven that a program which helps the child to be a self-reliant and independent. If I go about inclusive and with NOBES, yes, because we work with the children who are from marginalized community, from below the poverty line, from poor backgrounds, we don't keep any biases with the gender, with their caste, with their financial, with their HIV status, because for us, every child counts. So we make sure we should provide a same platform and equal opportunity to all the child. So yes, our one of our value, we focus the inclusive development, yes, because that is important, where we can keep and we can provide a same way, a same platform to every child who are aspiring to do good in the society. So yes, no biases for any child. For us, every child is equal and same. Every child counts. That means every penny counts, every contribution matters. Yes. So our value is yes, because as we say, every child counts. So single penny and single contribution matter for us. And we use and utilize the same for the betterment of the child. So, as our theme of committed community development does focus on child driven program, so our center is always focused the child protection and development. Our all program are directed towards the restoring childhood from children in crisis with comprehensive care protection of a shelter home, with rescue and rehabilitation integration with their family and extended institution. So under under child protection and the if I talk about the child protection program, which focus on the child rights and development, care and protection. So we support residential care program. A residential care program is an almost again, yes, it's a 3-decade old program. Under that, we support a child, a wholesome care, where we provide food, shelter, clothes, mental health, as well as independent life. Under that, we run and support a several shelter home from the different age group. So if I talk about, we support the child from the age of 2 to 21. So under that, we have a different program and different shelter room. And through the child have the journey, and we make sure the child till the age of 21 are independent, self-reliant, and also he or she can a better, you can say, a responsible person of the society, and also to support the other child. So under that, we have a shelter room. Name Ashray, in the sense a home where we support the child from the age group of 2 to 12. So from Ashray, so when the child complete the age group of 12, because they need to adolescence, they are no more child. So we divide the child into two different shelter homes. So for girls, we have a separate shelter home a program. And for the boys, we have a separate programs. And also we work closely with the child welfare community. So yes, so whatever we work, we keep updated. We work in the collaboration of National Child Welfare Committee. We are the part and integrated part of the program. So yes, we follow all the protocol policy, which is developed in the Juvenile Act, which is in follow in India. It's an JJ Act. And we work under the purview of that, and we work under the supervision of Child Welfare Committee. We make sure that child get a better protection and the development so that he can be a part of a responsible citizen. So so after Ashri, we divide the child, a boy child, when it's come to adolescence, we have a different shelter home, which is based in outskirts of Maharashtra, Lonavala, and a girl's shelter home, which is Ankur, where we support the girls adolescent from 13 to 18. And after that, we have our own shelter, which you can say aftercare program, where we support the child to be an independent citizen with a vocational training. We make sure they complete their graduation. We support them and link with the jobs where they can learn how to survive in the society without the support. We are the moral support, and we see and we support in that way. So in like in the last 3 decades, we have supported more than 600 children, and they are still part of CCD as alumni, because we always engage them through their several other programs, and we make sure we are there for them always and ensure that they also be a part of a society to share the good messages. So our vision says that the world where every child counts, a world of children living in dignity. So you can see the vision itself has a great impact, where we envisage that every child should have their dignity, should have their identity, because when we a supporter, when we get a child, when we receive a child from child welfare community or any, so mostly we get a child who are abandoned from the family, who are run away, who are lost, begging case, or the children who lost their parents. And most of the time, like they are a kind of orphan. I will not say an orphan, because we are there as a parents and parenting support, but they lost their everything. So we are here to support, to provide them identity, and we make sure they live with a dignity in the society. So that's our vision stand for. I'll talk about the mission. Mission is nothing like, yes, we facilitate the community action by enabling children and their family into the self-reliance along the principle of childless equity and justice. Yes. So we are a kind of facilitator where we support the child to make sure that child who are in, to make them to work on their rights protection and to develop in the way that he or she become a responsible citizen, self-reliant reliant person in the society. Yes, I have just shared about our residential care program. Yes, I would like to introduce a program where which is our core program. And why this is a core program? Yes, because here we get the opportunity to nurture the child and to prepare a responsible citizen. So our residential care program provides a comprehensive care to children who are living in a shelter home with living with HIV/AIDS, with the aim of restoring wholesome childhood for children in crisis, providing them with opportunity for growth development until they are either reintegrated or self-reliant. CCDT USP, if I'll say it, so we support the child who are mostly we receive a child from child welfare committee. In India, there are very minimal organizations who support HIV infected or affected. We can say still this epidemic, the globally, we are working on this epidemic. HIV, still we have a stigma and discrimination. Country like India, HIV is one of the, that taboo, it's still there. And though we are far ahead, though we have used the medicine, we know there is a medicine, but still the stigma is, and discrimination still, it's a part of the, it's a part of the life of the infected and affected family, which one of the reason to stop their growth and development. So yes, we have decided to support the child who are infected by HIV and AIDS, or who are the less lost their parents by HIV AIDS. So yes, and we keep them together to make sure that, so if you talk about the discrimination, main reason in India, I think it's a global issue where we have a stigma and discrimination of people. Those if somebody knows about the status, the ignores, connects, avoiding that person. So make sure that they keep things together. The other children, the HIV is just an advice. It's nothing else. So this is what the area we have now advocate in the community who are working for the HIV AIDS. And now they are doing the advocacy on this issue. So this stigma and discrimination, and also we closely work with national
just working on reconnection.
I am so sorry. I am Runjhun. I am co-host with Deepak. I think
there's some network issue.
Yes, you are. Deepak, we lost you in between. I think you were talking about the residential care program and our shelter homes. It would be great if you could just start with the... So we have like a small video. About our residential care program. And we would really like to play it for you. Deepak, could you just play it?
Yes. So I would like to take 3 minutes of your time and play a video that is having an essence of a residential care program, which is where we talk about every child count. Sorry for the network issue and glitches. Just a minute. Give me 1 minute. Hello, Runjhun. The video is visible.
Yes, it is. Yes.
And the audio.
I think that you have some network issue, Deepak. I'll play the video. You can just turn your screen sharing off. I'll do it.
Let's stop the video then.
Together, we can make it happen. Give every child a chance.
Hi, so this was a video that was shot in Ashray, which is one of our shelter homes in Mumbai, in Bandra. Deepa, could you just move to the next slide and full screen it? Yeah, this one.
So my slide is visible?
Yes, just full screen it. Just double click on it. So like the song was all about together, how we can do make things happen together. In this slide, like we would really like to talk about our biggest assets. Like we really, really believe that, you know, together we can make it happen. And our biggest asset is the community. When we say community, we mean the most vulnerable and the most marginalized communities we work with every day. We are talking about children and adolescents that live with us, and when they become the alumni, when they reintegrate with their families, then also they are a part of our family. Deepak, would you like to take a head from here?
Thank you, and thank you for sharing the video. So yes, so coming to our strength, yes, our biggest strength is our community. When we talk about the community, which means children, our marginalized community, vulnerable community. We work with them on a daily basis. Our grassroots team who are every day with their context, supporting the various, we keep them engaged with event and make sure they are part of the government program. So that is our strength talking about the community. Yes, we are here because of the community and we are always be for the community. Talking about the tools, yes, we have very hardworking team. Resilience and determination, that is so talking about the community still have presence, the government stakeholder, which our team most strong. We have a great network of our government partner stakeholder, make sure that our determination towards the resolutions of the yes, that's our tool. We always talk about the resilience and the determination. Yes, our role, yeah. So we understand that the community have the potential. So we are just a facilitator to manifesting and helping them to become a self-reliant. So we are there in the community to support the system, to support the community, to support the adults and children, to make sure that they are self-reliant and become a responsible citizen. So as I share that we are here, community, the community, and we will get the spirit and we'll keep working the community to empower them. So yes, the community is our core of the program. Going forward, we are making sure that we are going to empower the children in the community. Alumni of the program is the Sarge to take this lead role in driving the program to his desire. Yes, as I so say that we support so far more than alumni, and now they are a part of society and driving our program. So they are directly, indirectly associated with committed community development trust and supporting us to drive the community strength program. The restoring wholesome childhood, the children who are in crisis with the community. We keep updating our program as the community needs and requirements. We believe that nobody can understand better than the community. We support them to solve their problems.
I think we've lost Deepak again. So I'm really sorry, I'm going to take over from here. So he was talking about the residential care programs. It is one of our flagship program that we host at Committed Communities Development Trust. And we have some stories shared by the alumni that I would really like to play for you all. So I'm just going to share my screen and play the first one.
मेरा नाम लक्ष्मी प्रजापति है। मैं 22 साल की हूँ। जब मैं 9 महीने की थी तभी से मैं सीसीडीटी के शेल्टर होम में आई हूँ। जब मेरे को कुछ समझ भी नहीं था तभी से मैं सीसीडीटी में रहती हूँ। मेरे को होश भी नहीं था तभी से मैं सीसीडीटी में रहती हूँ। और सीसीडीटी को ही मैंने अपना घर मान लिया था। मेरा बचपन ही सीसीडीटी में गुजरा था। और जब मैं बड़ी हो गई तब मेरे पढ़ाई हो गई तो मैंने आगे के बारे में सोचा कि क्या करने का, क्या कर सकती हूँ, क्या करना चाहिए। तो काउंसलर सीसीडीटी के काउंसलर से बात करके मैंने मदद लिया कि मैं क्या कर सकती हूँ। तो उन्होंने मेरे को ऑप्शन दिया कि तू ये कर सकती है, ये कर सकती है करके तुम ये करो करके। तो मैंने नर्सिंग का कोर्स के लिए चुना। तो पैरामेडिकल नर्स का कोर्स किया मैंने। अभी मैं वो काम करती हूँ, वो मुझे आता है। तो मैं अभी हॉस्पिटल में काम पे हूँ। उधर मैं बच्चों की डिलीवरी करती हूँ, पेशेंट की देखरेख करती हूँ। मुझे अच्छा लगता है ये सब करना। मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है पेशेंट की देखरेख करना, उधर काम करना अच्छा लगता है। उसके बाद मैं अभी बैंक का सेविंग कैसा करने का वो मेरे समझ में नहीं था। तो मैंने सीसीडीटी के मदद से मैंने बैंक का सेविंग करना सीखा। उन्होंने मुझे सिखाया कि पैसे सेविंग कैसा करना, किधर पैसे लगाना, किधर नहीं लगाना। उसके मदद से सीसीडीटी के मदद से मैंने खुद का बैंक अकाउंट खोला। उनके मदद से सीसीडीटी ने मुझे खुद का बैंक अकाउंट खोल के दिया ताकि मैं पैसे सेविंग कर सकूँ। मैं दुनिया को दिखाना चाहती हूँ मैं क्या कर सकती हूँ और मैं कर रही हूँ। मुझे अच्छा लगता है मैं ये सब करती हूँ। नर्सिंग का कोर्स वगैरह इसमें सीसीडीटी ने मुझे बहुत सपोर्ट किया। और उसके बाद मैं बैंक सेविंग का अकाउंट खोल के दिया सीसीडीटी ने। उसके बाद मैं अभी खुद का भाड़े पे रूम लेके शेल्टर होम के कुछ लड़की लोग जो अभी सीसीडीटी से निकले हैं वो भी मेरे साथ 4-5 लोग रहते हैं, मेरे अंडर रहते हैं, उनको भी मदद करती हूँ। मुझे अच्छा लगता है। मैं भी चाहती हूँ कि मैं भी सीसीडीटी के जैसी आगे लोगों को मदद करूँ।
सो दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ अ गर्ल। हर नेम इज लक्ष्मी। शी इज अ 22 ईयर ओल्ड गर्ल। शी केम टू सीसीडीटीज आश्रय व्हेन शी वाज जस्ट 9 मंथ्स ओल्ड। I'm going to translate her story for you because she is saying this in Hindi and I would like to translate it for you all. So Lakshmi's story is very inspiring because she thinks that she was very young and she did not know she did not know anything because she was very young when she came at first. And now she has grown up with CCDT and ASHRAE. And now that she has completed her education, she did. She was very confused what she wanted to do to make a good future, a bright future. So she requested CCDT's team to get her some counseling session. And after the counseling session, she decided to do a course on paramedical. I'm sorry, I do not understand what that is exactly. After the paramedical course she did, another course for nursing, and now she's a nurse with two hospitals. She helps people with deliveries and taking care of patients. And she says that she really enjoys it. She is also talking that she also says that she wanted to learn how to save money because she wanted to secure her future. So with CCDT's help and a little bit of counseling, she has finally opened her bank account. Right now, she is staying on a rented in a rented apartment, and she has. There are two other girls from the residential care programs only who are living with her, but she doesn't take rent from them because she is earning well. She has finally, with the help again, with the right support, she's been able to start the loan processes, and she's going to buy a house for herself soon. I'm going to play it, and she's going to just finish the story.
और अभी भाड़े पे रूम ले रही हूँ और अभी बैंक का लोन का काम हो गया है ऑलमोस्ट. अभी कुछ दिन में मैं खुद के रूम में रहने जाऊंगी सीसीटीवी के मदद से. मैंने खुद का रूम लिया है अभी जो सीसीटीवी के मदद से कंप्लीट हुआ है, इसीलिए थैंक यू.
Hello, Runjan. I think we have one more video.
Yes. Can I play the other video too?
Yes.
मैं 10 साल पहले ज्वाइन हुआ था करीबन 2007 में. उस टाइम पे मैं एंड मेरी सिस्टर हम दोनों थे. एंड मेरी स्टोरी ऐसी है कि आज से 12 साल या 13 साल पहले जब मेरे डैड गुजरे थे तो हमें किसी ने सहारा नहीं दिया. एंड हमारे जो घर वालों थे उन्होंने हमें घर के बाहर कर दिया था. उस टाइम पे हमें मुझे तो पता नहीं था क्योंकि मैं छोटा था कि हमें क्यों निकाला गया, क्यों सपोर्ट कोई नहीं दे रहा है हमें, क्या रीज़न है. उस टाइम पे हमें ये सब चीज़ें बातें पता नहीं कि लाइफ में क्या चल रहा है क्या नहीं. एंड कहाँ रह रहे, डैड गुजर गए, मम्मी तबीयत खराब है. सो उस टाइम पे कुछ एक्चुअल में समझ नहीं आ रहा था कि हो क्या रहा लाइफ में. फिर थोड़े दिन ऐसे हुए जहाँ पे हमें घर से पूरा बाहर थे हम. एंड हमें घर वालों ने स्टेशन पे ला के छोड़ दिया, मुझे, मेरे सिस्टर को एंड मम्मी को. तो जो सीसीटीवी की जो आउटरीच वर्कर थे उनसे हमारी मुलाकात हुई स्टेशन पे. वो हमसे मिले, मुझे एक्चुअल में पहला मुझे मिले एंड मुझे पूछताछ करने लगे कि कहाँ पे रहता है, किधर है, यहाँ पे क्या कर रहे हैं स्टेशन पे. तो जब मैं उनसे बातचीत किया तो उन्होंने बोला चल दे मम्मी से मिला. सो मैंने उनको लेके गया मम्मी के पास कि बोला देखो क्या है, कुछ पूछ रहे. सो उन्होंने मम्मी से बातचीत की एक दिन पहले क्या है क्या, मुझे तो कुछ समझ नहीं रहा था उस टाइम पे. फिर वो चले गए, एक दिन हुआ वो चले गए, बातचीत किए चले गए. फिर अगले दिन वो आए 10-11 बजे, फिर एक उस टाइम पे हुआ है. एंड उनके साथ में एक दो जन और थे. फिर उन्होंने ना हमारा जो सामान था एक्चुअली वो उधर ही छोड़ दिया एंड हमें उन्होंने लेके बांद्रा में आए आश्रय में, जहाँ पे सीसीडी की एक रेसिडेंशियल केयर प्रोग्राम चलता है वहाँ पे उन्होंने हमें रखा। जब स्टार्टिंग में जब हम लोग आए थे तो हमारे कपड़े पूरा फटे हुए थे एंड एकदम अलग कंडीशन था। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हम लोग तो बहुत खुश हो गया कि फर्स्ट टाइम चलो अच्छे कपड़े मिले पहने, हम लोग ने देखा कि चलो एक अलग लाइफ है, यहाँ पे अलग अलग बच्चे हैं, उन्होंने खाना दिया खाने के लिए सो अच्छा लगा एंड मम्मी को एक अलग से रूम में रखा। एंड फिर दो तीन दिन हो गया बातचीत करते करते, मुझे तो अच्छा नहीं लग रहा था, अलग जगह आया था मेरी बहन उसको अच्छा लग रहा था सो वो वहाँ पर रहने लगे एंड मम्मी भी साथ में ही थी, अलग से एक रूम था उस टाइम पे वुमेन्स के लिए भी चलता था तो मम्मी भी थी। तो ऐसे करके एक साल तक मम्मी वहाँ पे थी एंड एक साल के बाद मम्मी बाहर निकली एंड हम लोग वहीं पे थे। जब मम्मी बाहर निकली एक साल के बाद एंड फिर मम्मी दो साल तक मम्मी जॉब कर रही थी 24 घंटे एंड फिर वो जॉब करके मम्मी ने कुछ थोड़ा फार सेविंग किया था। सो फिर 2011 में मुझे री इंटीग्रेट कराई मम्मी ने, आश्रय से बाहर निकाले। सो जब उस टाइम पे निकाला तो मैं स्कूल में पढ़ता था एंड मेरी सिस्टर वहीं पे थी, मीन्स उसे नहीं निकाला एंड हम लोग वहीं पे थे, मुझे निकाला था एंड उसके बाद उन्होंने बोला कि आप लेके जाओ इसे, इसका जो पढ़ाई का खर्चा है हम देंगे, जैसे मेरी मम्मी को कहा गया। फिर देन उन्होंने मुझे बाहर मम्मी ने लेके आई एंड देन फिर मैं रहने लगा एंड फिर उन्होंने मेरा स्कूल में एडमिशन किया इंग्लिश मीडियम में, जहाँ पे मेरी फिर से पढ़ाई चालू हो गई एंड मेरी सिस्टर आश्रय में थी जो बांद्रा में। दो तीन साल चार साल बीतने के बाद मैं जब 7th 8th में आया तब मैंने एक जगह पे HIV वर्ड सुना कि HIV एड्स के बारे में सुना मैंने। तो इसके बारे में मैंने थोड़ा नेट पे सर्च वगैरह किया कि एक्चुअल में ये चीज़ क्या है क्या नहीं, सो मुझे उसके बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन पता चला। देन एक दिन मैंने देखा कि मम्मी मेडिसिन खा रही थी तो मैंने पूछा क्या चीज़ के बारे में, तो उन्होंने मुझे बताया कि इस चीज़ के बारे में मेडिसिन, तो मुझे थोड़ा शौक जैसे ही लगा कि मम्मी मेडिसिन खा रही थी इनसे इतने साल से इस चीज़ के बारे में।
So this is the story of Vikas. Vikas lost his father when he was just 7 years old. And after his father passed away, his family abandoned him, his sister and his mother. So they had to stay on the at the railway platform for many days. They were finally taken under the care of CCDT. They were taken to Ashray. Ashray is primarily for underprivileged children, but his mother was also taken under the care. They started living there. It was when they had come to CCDT's Ashray, it was their condition was not very good. Their clothes were torn. They did not have anything to eat. They had not eaten for a very long time. After they started living with us, he realized that his mother had been taking a medicine and he had no idea about that, what it was for. And it was later that he realized that his mother had caught HIV/AIDS. He was very young, so he had no idea what HIV was. Then he started to read about it and he started asking people about it. I'm going to continue the story.
So, मैंने पूरा पूछताछ किया कि क्या कैसे हुआ, कब हुआ था, क्या था, तो मुझे पता चला कि डैड के थ्रू हुआ था एंड जब वो गुजर गए तो घर वालों ने इसकी वजह से सपोर्ट नहीं किया एंड उन्होंने बाहर कर दिया था एंड तब एक सीसीडी की दीदी थी जो हमें वहाँ पे मिली थी एंड उन्होंने लेके गया बताया कि हाँ यहाँ पर एक ऐसी संस्था भी है जो ऐसे लोगों को बोला जाए तो एक HIV कम्युनिटी के लिए काम करती है जहाँ पे तुम्हारे बच्चे रह सकते हैं। सो उन्होंने मुझे पूरा स्टोरी बताया तो पता चला कि जब हम गए थे तो टेस्टिंग हमारा हुआ था तो मम्मी सिस्टर पॉजिटिव थे एंड मैं नेगेटिव हुआ एंड मुझे पढ़ाई का खर्चा भी सीसीडीटी से मिल रहा है। सो ये सब मुझे ऐसा लगा कि एक ऐसी संस्था है जो लोगों को एजुकेशन सपोर्ट दे रही है, मीन्स आज के टाइम पे बहुत ही है, क्योंकि मेरे लाइफ में आज अगर मैं पढ़ा लिखा नहीं रहता, मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है, कभी सोचा भी नहीं था कि इतना पढ़ लिखेंगे। मैं आज 12th हो गया है, फर्स्ट ईयर में एडमिशन किया BSC IT में, उन्होंने 69-10th तक मुझे सपोर्ट किया था, एंड अभी मैं खुद के पैर पर खड़ा हूँ, जहाँ पे मैं खुद कमा रहा हूँ एंड अपने आगे की पढ़ाई का खर्चा भी ये कर रहा हूँ, एंड अभी फ़िलहाल हाल ही में जॉब पे भी लगा हूँ, एंड मैं CCTV में भी जॉब कर रहा है। एक्चुअली एक न्यू प्रोजेक्ट आया परिवर्तन करके, जिसमें एज अ कम्युनिटी ऑर्गेनाइज़र जॉब करने का मुझे एक डेजिग्नेशन मिला, एक मौका मिला कि जहाँ पे मैं काम कर सकता हूँ, एंड इसी साथ में मैं क्लासेस भी पढ़ाता हूँ, जहाँ पे मैं 1st to 10th के बच्चों को पढ़ाता हूँ, एंड मेरे पास अभी नहीं मिला कि 40-50 स्टूडेंट्स हैं जो मैं घर पे उन्हें पढ़ाता हूँ। सो मैं थैंक यू कहना चाहूँगा CCTV को, कि जो एक हमें जहाँ थे हम जिस पोजीशन पे थे एंड आज हमें जिस पोजीशन पे मैं हूँ, सिर्फ उन्हीं के वजह से हूँ, क्योंकि जिस टाइम पे मुझे किसी ने सपोर्ट नहीं किया, उस टाइम पे मेरे साथ CCTV ने मुझे सपोर्ट दिया, मैं मम्मी को।
सो After he realized that his mother had HIV, he was obviously worried about his future and how he was going to manage. So his education was supported by CCTT, and now he has completed his education. He completed his 12th standard and then got into graduation program. And now that his education is completed, he has started working. So he teaches tuition to children. He has got 50 children under him and he's teaching them. And he has also joined Committed Communities Development Trust, another project called Parivartan, which works for HIV affected adolescents. He has joined the team and he is trying to make a difference. So that's his story. I would really request Deepak to take it over from here and move to the next slide.
Thank you so much, Ranjan. You're a great support system. I think I have many network glitches. So my slide is visible, Ranjan?
Yes, Deepak, it's visible. Please make it full screen.
So, now?
No, it's still not. Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I think the network it's pretty bad here over here. I think it's raining over here. It's because of that. So thank you so much. So we have thank you for running the video, which is inspiring. Yes, and these are our alumni, a part of CCTV intern program, and yes, they are the change maker, and they are associated with CCTV and making sure this community becomes self-inspiring, and they share this very story. And we are like privileged to have this alumni with us who have done a tremendous successful life journey, and now they are a person who are inspiring others by sharing their story. So yes, I'll talk about the Restoring Wholesome Childhood to the Children in Crisis. Yes, this is our major goal. By this, we provide care and protection to children in crisis. Yes, we make sure we provide care and support and nurture their overall growth and development. Yes, our main agenda and focus to rehabilitate and reintegrate with children with their family or larger community. So yes, by supporting their nurture, their child and growth till the development, they become a self-reliant. So we have recently seen the story of change, where our change leader were sharing their story. Such an inspiring story. We have many more, but I think due to the network, we wanted to bring them live. But I think, as you are aware, in India, the network plus they are, the technical part having limited technical resource. So we have decided to pre-record their story and like to showcase they are inspiring to the others.
Yes. So I would like to
thanks. I'm so glad to be a part of this ABCD conference value. We are so happy that we got this opportunity to share our story and to gather many more inspiring stories from others. Yes, ABCD Conference, yes, we believe in a program that emerged from a community need. We work as a catalyst of change and transfer the ownership to the community once the goal is achieved. Yes, CCDT complements and supplements the government efforts to strengthen the right-based intervention for children in crisis. I would like to open our session for queries. Feel free to write question in chat box with your name, country, and we are happy to answer your question. We end up presentation and we are open for Q&A. Thank you so much for your patience and time. Sorry for the network glitches. And thank you everyone who has supported our presentation. So yes, we are here. Open for question answer round.
Thank you so much for your presentation. I know that at times it was a little bit difficult with the technology, but
I think now I can on my video.
The message certainly came through, and I think that it's really fantastic the work which you're doing and how you're supporting so many different people in a variety of ways.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Anyone has any question, we are here to answer. We are still happy to share. So I think,
we have a question from Mr. Ashok. He is asking if this community boy Vikas has joined the who got support from CCDT is helping others in the community. Yes, he is helping others in the community. He has joined our project. He is on board with us, and he is he goes out on the field and does all the work, and whatever he has learned or whatever he has experienced, he kind of shares his experience with others also.
Yeah.
We would be very happy to answer many more questions. I mean, if you all wanted to shoot your questions. There's another request that I would want to make. If you could just share your email IDs with us, that would be great. Just in the chat box.